Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
50 years ago to date, Mrs. Indira Gandhi nationalized India's banks. 14 then, but then accounting for more than 90% of India's banking system. So effectively, he turned India's banking system into a government department. Now, 50 years later, it's time to assess what impact it had, but it's also time to raise a question, especially to the current government and to the BJP, which is, was this a good decision by Mrs. Gandhi or a bad decision? If it was a good decision, I have never heard any BJP leader ever say that this was a good decision by Mrs. Gandhi. They say Bangladesh, the war was a good decision, but I have never heard them say that this was a good decision. So they are not willing to say this was a good decision, but they are not willing to call it a bad decision or to reverse it also. Now, I can say in fairness that Narendra Modi has tried a little bit, but he is stepping very gingerly, and his effort has been first to consolidate some bad banks, put them together, then maybe to reduce some equity going ahead. But so far, what has he done? So far, since he came to power, 2.7 trillion rupees, that is 2,70,000 crore rupees, have been shoved into these banks as fresh capital because they were collapsing under the weight of their bad loans. In this budget also, another 70,000 crores has been allocated. Under his watch, these banks, which are all listed on stock markets, have lost nearly 300 billion, that is 2.97 lakh crores of value in market cap. And yet, nobody is willing to say this was a mistake. We are now trying to reverse it. Because once again, as I said, there is some effort, but it is very, very careful, very cautious, and very slow, and may take a lifetime. Now, how did this happen 50 years ago? Let me try and declutter the economics and politics of bank nationalization. Now, in 1969, 50 years ago, Mrs. Gandhi signaled a hard left turn to India's political economy, or her own political economy. This was not ideological. She was not a left ideologue. This was born out of the internal fight within the Congress party. After Lal Bahadur Shastri's sudden death, she had become prime minister. Many seniors in her party had not accepted it, particularly her main challenger and his deputy, that is Morarji Desai, who was her finance minister, who had the reputation of being a little more on the right. He was by no means a right libertarian, but a little more on the right. Now, how does she isolate, or how does she corner this old guard? So she got them to criticize public sector. She encouraged them. They were criticizing public sector and saying India needs more private enterprise, etc. And once she had them boxed in, the oldies or syndicate as they were called, I am oversimplifying it, she signaled her own hard left turn with an ordinance one Saturday to nationalize all of India's banks, most of India's banks. And then it came up in Parliament. So that immediately fired the imagination of the poor. That got the left parties immediately to come to her support. And that isolated, or that cornered, these older people in the Congress. And then she built her new politics around that. She did other things. She abolished the privy purses of the princes, and then many other nationalizations, and ran 6 years of very strongly socialist left-wing government, effects of which we still see. Now, when this bill was debated in Parliament, a lot of the opposition questioned it. BJP, or Jan Sangh as it was then, a little bit mildly, but the strongest criticism came from Swatantra Party, which was the last Indian party of the economic right, had some really eminent parliamentarians and wonderful people. One of them was late Minoo Masani. And I quote, my colleague Achyut Mishra has done some research for me, and I have looked at parliamentary proceedings of that debate. And I quote a few lines from what Minoo Masani said. He said that this bank nationalization will lead to three evils. One, bureaucratic red tape and inefficiency, 2, political influence, graft and corruption, and 3, like almost all state enterprises, these will also make a loss. He said this 50 years ago. Just see how prescient he is proven to be, because these banks have proved him right on each one of these 3. Now, there may have been some benefits initially from nationalization, particularly because in the 60s, some banks, private banks, used to fail and depositors used to lose their money. But if you weigh everything, this has been a very damaging turn in India's economy. In any case, whatever it is, it had ended its use by date almost 30 years ago, and some bit of reform should have started. Some happened, at least when the banks were listed on stock exchanges, a few other changes were made, but not enough. They've continued to be government owned, and that's why they are in this situation. Today, if you look at the state of nationalized banks and India's banking sector overall, again, very basic data. In answer to a parliament question in March, government said that public sector banks had 63% of India's deposits in the banking system, 58% of the loans, but 85% of all of India's bad debts. In fact, today the number may be higher. It may be even 90-92%. Now, this is humongously bad. And this tells you that if these banks lived by any principle of the market, they would have all, except a couple, certainly State Bank, the rest would have rolled over and died. Because no other shareholder has such endless pockets that they can keep on putting in more money, or no other shareholder is like the government, which has the mint with it. It can print more money and throw that money there. So time has now come to reflect on whether it is worthwhile shoving more money into these endless pits. Because again, Minoo Masani had said that Mrs. Gandhi is hoping to lay her hands on public deposits of people and powering them into the gutter of public enterprise. Today, nobody in parliament would say so, but he said so, and he was proven right. So, on the 50th anniversary, time to reflect. We know that Narendra Modi is driven by politics more than economics. So, nobody wants to say anything bad about public sector companies. Nobody wants to privatize anything. But he also knows that he cannot keep throwing more money behind these banks now. Because there are many ways you can address it. You can address it slowly, just as Government of India, various governments have addressed telecom and aviation. What's been done there is no public sector company has been privatized or sold, but you've allowed other private sector come up, and private sector has grown and public sector has become marginalized. So in effect, while public sector companies have not been privatized, no BSNL, no MTNL, no Air India as yet, but the sectors have become privatized. Today, aviation does not depend on Air India. Today, telecom does not depend on BSNL, MTNL. So you might say, all right, I will let all public sector banks be. Meanwhile, private sector will come and take over. But banking, as TNINN says in an article that we are publishing today's weekly column, banking is a different matter. Also, the gap between private banks and public sector banks is too large. Then the capital requirements for banks are very, very large. So time has now come to start rolling back. Time has also come for somebody to stand up in parliament, at least from the BJP, and say what Mrs. Gandhi did was a mistake. It was her biggest economic blunder. This was so major that we could not have reversed it in 5 or 6 or 7 years. But we have now started the process of doing it. I don't think anybody will say it, but I'll be very happy if somebody said it. It's a wish. And before concluding, I will also remind my friends, the BJP, of something that another leader in the same parliament, who they are more familiar with than Minoo Masani, had said while intervening in the debate on bank nationalization. His name was Atal Bihari Vajpayee. So what did Atal Bihari Vajpayee say in 1969? He said that with this sudden step, Mrs. Gandhi was trying to become Hitler, and India will never accept a Hitler. He also said anybody who tries to become an Adhinayak, which means anybody who tries to become a dictator or Badshah of India, will be dismantled by the people of India. This country will not accept dictatorship. And then he also used four expressions to characterize what she was doing with this bank nationalization ordinance and bill. So once again, a word for my BJP friends, that any time you have doubts about bank nationalization and how to handle it, remember the words of Atal Bihari Vajpayee: ashobhaniya, ugly, anuchit, improper, akaran, without justification, anavashyak, unnecessary. That should be the guiding principle, because this was a bad decision, and time has now come 50 years later to turn your backs on it.